All right, guys, welcome to round three with our sweet, mostly mono blue artifact deck on Channel 5 Roll. I want to play first. This hand seems good. I like it. Got this turn one dock hand. This guy's going to be attacking all day. Tap X untapped artifacts. You control. So if we have one prism, we can look at one prism. Which we do. Get in there, you little artifact man. What do we hit? Oh, alright. Alright. Okay. This guy's lifting a lot of weight. He's only got one power? That's weird. Huh. There's a lot of artifacts. Show me the artifacts. Do we think they have something that can kill this guy? Maybe? Might be worth holding back. Next turn we can start drawing a bunch of cards. That's pretty solid. Well, I guess we're drawing one card, but we're gonna get to, like, tap three. Look at the top three. Sure, you got old Renegade Wheelie. Oh, that's pretty good. Play that dude next turn off of this Prophetic Prism. So this guy's going to make Consulate Skygate unable to lock. You might just tap him. I'm not sure if drawing a card is... Like, it's basically we take three damage to draw a card. Also, Magic Online is lagging a little bit, so apologies for that. I think it's probably worth taking three. Like, we get to scry three. It's not even scrying, and they don't go to the bottom. Well, they do go to the bottom when we're done, right? Put the rest in the bottom in any order. Oh, I get to choose the order, too. God, we're basically stacking our deck here. This is not... Okay, just making sure it's not like, during your turn only, activate anytime you can play a sorcery. Yeah, next time we get the Maverick Thopterist, which is just great. Don't kill my merchant doc. Oh, a 3-2 for a 3? That guy's boring. No offense, buddy. One, two, three. Man, we get the impulse here. Look at the top three cards, put one in your hand. Boop. Let's take... Is it Reservoir Walker? Or is it Glimmy? I think it's Reservoir Walker. Oh, but Glimmer is actually great with, Torrential Gear Hulk. Whatever. Reservoir Walker's good with everything else on the board. Oh, how much does that guy cost? A lot still. Eight manners. So, Maverick Thopterists. We can tap the Prism. We have to tap Prism for a red. But then we can tap Skygate. I don't want to do that. I think we're just playing Reservoir Walker here. Fortunately, all of these artifacts are also creatures. Our hand is great, though. This dude's got a big old bucket of water on his back. That's a reservoir, stupid. Oh, God, you're right. Yeah, that guy's fine. If you want to tap that guy to attack, I'll be fine with it, I guess. Well, that's just fine. Oh, geez, this is an interesting choice. Oh, I guess they just make Reservoir Walker unable to block, then we still take three, so yeah, that's fine. Well, next turn we're going to have Maverick Thopterist. Yep. Block this dude. Oh, is that a thing we want to do? I don't care about any of these... Mono 3-2s over here. Add a red. So pay a red. Pay a blue, because we have to. We're not going to be using this guy, so we can put that to 2/1/2. We're still one shy is the problem. So we tap this guy. Boop. Now we have two. Tap one. And now we have to tap the pacification array. Which is fine. Let's them think we have something else. How many artifacts do we have? We can tap 1, 2, 3, 4. We can tap 6. We can look at the top 6 cards. That's ridiculous. Oh, dang. That's rude. We still have a million guys, though. And I have no problem double blocking, anything. So you make something unable to block. Ouch. I'll take a point. Hopefully you don't have two tricks. If you have multiple tricks, it's real bad for us. Metalwork Colossus is still only a... Actually, if they have Chandra's Helix here, it's real bad. They do one to this guy, and they do one to our double blockers here. So... One... Actually, we'll kill this guy. This guy's more problematic. Well, we'll try to kill this guy. They 100% have Chandra's Pyro Helix, right? It's not even close that they don't. Caught in the... Shock is not as bad, I guess. God, this Renegade Wheelie guy is really getting on my nerves. We do have Torrential Gearhulk to just block and kill it next turn. If we draw land. We did. We also just Shrewd Negotiation this guy. Give them something like Prism, because we don't need it anymore. But that does shut down our ability to play Metalwork Colossus. Oh, we can also just give them Reservoir Walker, which seems even better. Yeah, maybe that's what we want to do, and we steal this guy, and then we can just go block, block. Two. Actually, we have 6 mana. We can also just tap this guy down. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. We're going to tap that guy down and draw a card. Oh, but whenever it becomes tapped, then a guy can't block, right? So that's still bad. Yeah, let's just get rid of him, I guess. Shrewd Negotiation. I'm trying to click on it. Choose target artifact you control. This guy. This guy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright. Whatever. That's fine. I'd like to wait till we have a an instant in the graveyard for Torrential Gearhulk, but we only have like 2 or 3 in the deck. And one of them is at the bottom. Glimmer's at the bottom, so. Unfortunately, it is not Snapcaster, so we cannot Shrewd Negotiation a second time with our Torrential Gearhulk. Otherwise, people would be casting Cruel's Maidens in Modern for 6 mana and getting a 5/6 out of it. Man, super aggro. We're still at 12. Feeling pretty okay about that. They have more cards, but I'm pretty sure our cards are, you know, better. Plus we have Merchant Dock Hand and Pacification Array on the board. We get to untap with a running... Oh, dang it. They kill that guy over the Dock Hand. That's interesting to me. 2, 3, 4. This is great. Except we gave them a Reservoir Walker, which means we'll never draw cards from it. It does block all day, though. Oh, actually, we have Torrential Gearhulk and Metalwork Colossus, so drawing cards is not that far in the future, I would imagine. Oh. let's find out what happens. They have four cards in hand. That's like a, it's basically like a million cards. Who are we tapping down? 3-2, for obvious reasons. This guy just killed a bunch of things? What did this guy kill? Sky whales? Well, it's a harpooner, so I expected sky whales, but it turns out it's just a robot. Alright, we'll block with the wall, I guess. If you want to use a pump spell on an 0-4, you're more than welcome to. Well, that was exciting. Malfunction. Oh man, it's funny because it's still it makes the dude unable to block, but I'm not sure we care. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We're 2 mana away. God, I want to use this ability, but I can't. 2, 3, 4. Whatever, we'll just tap this guy. Who can't block? I remember the Pro Tour, I put a malfunction on one of Sam Black's creatures and he was like, okay. And he didn't tap it. So he's like gaming me to try to make sure I remember the trigger myself, otherwise I'm just gonna miss the trigger. So I'm like, I physically reach over and tap the creature for him. I'm like, can you tap this guy for me? Thanks. You're just making it inconvenient for me. But, I mean, it's the right thing to do. Like, it's a trigger. It's my responsibility to remember it. And it's just awkward because I'm like, really? You're not going to tap it for me? Why is he attacking with this guy? This is wasting time. I got things to do, man. Play another guy. Sure. Target artifact you control. Oh, well, I'm glad I helped you with that. Wait, what? Why didn't they kill the console at Sky? Oh, it's got hexproof. Yeah! Oh, that was great. Just fantastic. Oh, man. That was fantastic. Well, we're going to take a bunch of damage from this guy, though, so we have to actually... Ugh. God, how do we deal with that? Wow, I can't believe I gave you the one artifact. That's so sad. I think we're just going to pass here and draw with Merchant Dockhand because we can tap like 4 artifacts. Which, looking at the top 4 and drawing 1 is better than drawing 2 when we need to find an answer. Yep, that's pretty brutal. I think he forgot about the hexproof too. I think they were trying to trick us and be like, yeah, I'll kill your guy. I mean, obviously the card says hexproof, but you don't rely on that. Like, you're not reading your individual cards every single turn. Yeah, I'm just going to let them attack. I can't imagine you attack with Quicksmith Rebel here. So we're just going to block you. We're going to take 2, otherwise Padim dies. And we don't really have time to let Padim die. time? I don't even know if that makes any sense. We're going to go to 6, virtual 6. God, Quicksmith Rebel is real good and limited. Who saw that coming? Is it still game 1? I'm wondering if we just played out Torrential Gearhulk a million turns ago, if it would have just been better. 1, 2, 3, 4... Actual impulse. Bastion Inventor, Pacification Array, Aether Swooper doesn't do anything. Bastion Inventor is reasonable here. Another Pacification Array is virtually free with Metalwork Colossus. So is Bastion Inventor though. We're gonna take the Bastion Inventor. That guy's pretty good too. Jeez. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we can actually go implement here, which is basically free if we're going to cast this guy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We can just play both of these guys. We have 1. Yeah, we go to 4. We have to find an answer for. Can we just bounce our own guy? This guy should cost 3 if my math is correct. And it is. So we have 4 blockers. They have 1, 2, 3, 4 attackers, which is fine. We could just lose this guy. But then we get some real profitable blocks there if they choose to. Sure. Yep, just gonna pass here. We're at a virtual 4 because of the stupid Reservoir Walker that we gave them. We haven't even seen another artifact in this deck. Literally haven't seen a single other artifact from them. I think we might be dead. Man, I can't imagine the situation where I'm like, oh, I should have played around Quicksmith Rebel. Yeah, that's fine. Well, we did find another artifact, I guess. I doubt they're gonna attack here. Yep, sweet. So we get a one-turn reprieve there. And we get to draw from Padim, and we get to draw 2 from Implement. So this is actually 4 cards here, which is nice. Well, 2 of them being lands is less nice. So Gearhulk, we have enough mana for Gearhulk. Barricade Breaker we can do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We'd have 1 mana left over. And we definitely attack with Metalwork Colossus here, that's for sure. God, and the Untethered Express has Trample. Super rude. Why doesn't Metalwork Colossus have Trample? That's the question we're asking ourselves. 5, 6. We play the land. 2. Torrential Gearhulk blocking Untethered Express just seems better. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, I think that's fine. They have 1, 2. Yeah, we're gonna go to like 2 mana, 2 life. Oh my god, why don't we have an answer to Quicksmith Rebel and the stupid Reservoir Walker we gave them? That is just unbelievable to me. The problem is, even if they don't attack, we still have to play the Gear Hulk. Otherwise, it's just terrible. All right, we found another artifact, another 6/6 rare. Sweet. Yep, you got it. One. So they're like, oh, you didn't tap anything. You're right. And if they shoot Torrential Gear Hulk, it just gives an extra turn, which is great. Oh! Oh, that's fantastic. Now they can't... Oh, yes. Oh, that's beautiful. I thought that was a May ability at first. Oh, and they didn't actually shoot anything in response. Oh. This is working out quite well. And Torrential Gear Hulk has Hexproof. Oh, so they couldn't have shot Torrential Gear Hulk anyway because it has Hexproof. I keep forgetting. Yeah, this turned around quite well. Single block, hope you don't have... Yep, you don't. That guy goes to the trash can. We stay at 4. You no longer have a way to shoot my guys. Yeah, now we get to draw another card. Play this thing. Is it just Dragster here? Yeah, then we get a Thopter. I feel like we're in good shape now. So this guy, what does this guy cost the crew? 4? So you could do it. So we just attack with Colossus. It doesn't have Trample though, it's just a 6/6. So now we can actually play this guy for... So improvise. Oh, okay, we just win the game. Sweet. Yeah, alright, well, it didn't make us work for it. Whew. Alright. So, they have a ton of vehicles. 2 really good vehicles. Negate might be worth it. They also had Shock, which is... It's good when you get to counter it. The other malfunction might just be better than both of those. Like, it shuts down both the vehicles, which is great. Aether Swooper is just still not a card I'm super excited about. Yeah, I think actually that should be it. I don't think anything else is, like, super exciting to me. Yeah, seems fine. Alright, we can submit like this. Yeah, I think Malfunction's probably better than Negate. Alright. I don't know what to make of this hand. It's got a lot of mana. We're on the draw, we can keep this hand. It's pretty slow, but I'm going to assume we're going to draw. Actually, 5 lands, I mean the 6 lands on top. No, a Glimmer. Alright, well, I accept. I mean, he said oops last game in response to crewing the vehicle, but like, what's the alternative? Just never crewing a vehicle? That seems worse. This guy's very good. This guy's very aggressive for our slow hand. Ideally, we draw Consulate Skygate here. I feel like we're in bad shape if we don't. One time console sky. I'll even take a prophetic prison. Okay, 3 drop. Sure. God, I don't know how much damage we're going to take from this guy before we are able to deal with it. At least 3. No, oh, well, nothing else. That was nice. Oh wow, Prism. You're rude as heck. Prism actually draws as a card. Your implement doesn't. But implement's a little... Yeah, if we draw like something else, we can play that and Prism next turn, so... Right now, our plan is to malfunction this 3-1. It's not ideal, but it is a 3-1, so it's a reasonably solid dude. Plus, I'm not playing other things right now, which is interesting to me. Here we go. Now they're 100% playing something else. You're gonna make a tiny bro? A little baby, perhaps? Yeah. Sure, y'all. Okay. See, we can put Malfunction on this guy, but if we put it on this guy, we can actually play Innovator and block next turn. We take one less damage. So we go to 10, then we play Innovator next turn. Following turn, we can play both of these. Let's try not to die. Don't play anything. Just be like, I don't have any creatures left. Oh, that's great news. We could also play Padim, but that's not exciting. Yeah, I like 4-4 Hexproof better. Can't kill it. If you want to pump your motorists, like we're trading. So it's I presume we're trading unless you have +1/+0 in first strike. But then our Padim might be even safer because... Aww, that's super sad. Well, I guess we're taking 2 now. Man, just when you think he's stabilized. Can I get that reservoir guy? 3 life seems good. Why do you have another flyer, especially one that makes that veteran mode 3, 4, 5, 6? Ugh. What are we trying to hit here? We don't have a lot of flyers, which is sad. Let's draw 2 first. 2 seems better than 1, right? 3, 4, 5, 6 damage. I think we're just dead. Eddie Trailhawk is surprisingly good here. I thought we were stabilizing, but turns out we are not. If we're able to tap... Actually... Holy smokes. That was a great draw. I forgot that was in our deck. That's the first time we've even drawn this. Oh my goodness gracious. That is a card. That's the first time we've drawn Aether Sphere Harvester. And I hope you don't have another removal spell. And if we get to play Padim next turn, it has Hexproof, which is just ridiculous. Whew. All right. Feeling alive. If they attack, we block the motorist, maybe? Oh, yes. Oh, yes. We're alive. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. All the hexproof in the world. We're just gonna play Prism here. Start drawing cards next turn. Dragster. Glimmer also gives us 2 more energy for the Harvester. It doesn't have Vigilance, right? No, that's the other ridiculous vehicle in this set. Well, that's the heart of Kieran. This is just the heart of Harvest. Doesn't even make any sense. Yes. Yes! Alright, we're doing it. Shrewd negotiation. So 7, we can go tap Prism. So 5, 6, 7, 8. So we'd have 3 mana left over. We can go Dragster, Barricade Breaker. Wait, no, we want to play shrewd, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, we'd be shy some. God, I'm tempted to just steal the Eddie Trailhawk. Like, it blocks the Propeller Pioneer and it shuts off their, their ability to get flying to their guys, which is pretty relevant when we have no flyers. Six, seven, eight. We could just go Dragster Shrewd Negotiation, but I like having... I mean, I actually have Consulate Skygate, so... let's Barricade Break. 1, 2... And we'll play Skygate. God, everything has Hexproof. That's so brutal. I think we can get in there. Having an Aether Harvester with Hexproof and Lifelink is pretty brutal. If we had one more mana, we could actually play Dragster first. Paid one more. Yep, alright, sweet. Not surprised that we won that one. Alright, see you guys next time. We'll be right back.